Hello, my name is Juan Gómez Luna, and I'm a senior researcher in the Safari Research Group at ETH Zurich. I'm going to briefly introduce our work, Understanding a Modern Processing in Memory Architecture, Benchmarking and Experimental Characterization. In current computing systems, data movement between the memory and storage units and the compute units is a major contributor to execution time and energy consumption. Processing in memory is a paradigm that can tackle this data movement bottleneck. Although explored for many years, technology challenges prevented from the successful materialization of PIM in commercial products. UPMM has designed and fabricated and now commercializes the first publicly available real-world processing in memory architecture, which consists of DDR4 chips containing small processors called DRAM processing units or DPUs. Our work is an introduction to the UPMM PIM architecture and programming model, a characterization of the DPU, and a benchmarking and workload suitability study. Main contributions of our work are a comprehensive characterization and analysis of the first commercially available PIM architecture, and PRIM, the first benchmark suite for a real-world processing in memory architecture. PRIM contains 16 workloads that are memory bound in conventional processors, and we characterize these workloads with a strong and weak scaling experiments. We also compare them to their CPU and GPU counterparts. Main takeaways of our work are workload characteristics for PIM suitability, programming recommendations, suggestions and hints for hardware and architecture designers of future PIM systems, and the PRIM benchmark suite that can serve as programming samples and for evaluation and comparison of current and future PIM systems. In a typical UPMM-based PIM system, we find a host CPU, some DRAM DIMMs that are the main memory, and some UPMM DIMMs that are the PIM-enabled memory. Inside each of these PIM chips, we find 8 DRAM banks that are called NRAM and 8 DPUs. One key observation from our work is that the saturation point of DPUs is very, very low throughout different data types and operations. This leads us to key takeaway number one. The UPMM PIM architecture is fundamentally compute bound, and as a result, we expect that most suitable workloads are very memory bound in conventional processors. Another key takeaway from our comparison to CPU and GPU is that the most well-suited workloads for the UPMM PIM architecture are those that don't use arithmetic operations or only use simple operations like bitwise operations or integer addition and subtraction. Another key takeaway is that the most suitable workloads are those that require little or no communication across DPUs. One important key takeaway from our work is that the UPMM-based PIM systems that we have tested outperform state-of-the-art CPUs in terms of performance and energy efficiency on most PRIM benchmarks. And they also outperform state-of-the-art GPUs on a majority of PRIM benchmarks, and the outlook is even more positive for future PIM systems. UPMM-based PIM systems are more energy efficient than state-of-the-art CPUs and GPUs on workloads that they provide performance improvements over the CPUs and the GPUs. And the reason is that the source of both performance improvements and energy savings is the reduced data movement between memory and processors that PIM systems can provide. You can find all the details of our work in our paper and our public repository. Thank you very much for your attention.